Hi, this is Professor Jim A. Chen at California State University, Long Beach. In this video lesson today, we'll look at set builder notation and interval notation for describing sets of real numbers. Well, first, what do we mean by a set? A formal definition of a set is a collection of similar objects. For example, a set of alphabets can be denoted as S equals, this is the set notation, the curly braces, A, B, C, D, E, and so on. Well, there are 26 alphabets to write. It's way too much to write. Hence, we're going to use three dots to describe everything in between, all the way to the last alphabet, Z. In this set notation here, the letter S is the name of the set. Each one of those alphabets is called an element in the set. If something is found in the set, then we write, for example, the alphabet C is an element of the set S. So we use this symbol here to denote an element of. This means that C can be found in the set S. If something is not found in the set, for example, the number 2, and we denote this by 2 is not an element in the set S. So we use this slash to go through the element symbol to mean that it's not found in the set. When the elements in the set satisfy a certain property, then we can use what we call the set builder notation to describe it. For example, the set of all real numbers that is greater than negative 1 and less than 8 can be written as S, which is the set of all x such that x is a real number and x is between negative 1 and 8. In this notation, the x here is an element in the set S. This vertical bar here is called the such that, basically saying that whatever follows the vertical line is the conditions that everything in the set S satisfies. So in this case, everything in the set S must be a real number and must be between negative 1 and 8. On the other hand, if I tell you that the set T is a set of all y such that 0 is less than or equal to y is less than or equal to 7, what would you say about the set in words? For example, if I tell you that the set S1 is a set that has the element 1, 2, and 3, and set S2 is a set that contains elements 3, 4, and 5, set S3 is a set that contains element 4, 5, and 6, would then be S1 union S2. What about S1 intersection S2? And what about S1 intersection S3? Well, take a moment and think about what you would write for the answers for these questions. If we think about this question using a graphical representation called the Venn diagram, we can describe S1 as a set that has element 1, 2, and 3, and S2 is a set that has element 3, 4, and 5. But 3 is an element that they actually have both in common, so I would draw another circle here that contains 3 in the set 2. This first portion is S1, this second one is S2. When I say S1 union S2, I'm including all elements that are found in set S1 or that's found in S2. Graphically, that represents everything in both circles. But we were right. The set 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Notice that the element 3 actually appears in both set 1 and set 2, but when we list it out, we only have to list once. On the other hand, if you want to look at the intersection of sets, using the same Venn diagram, S1 will have elements 1, 2, 3, S2 has element 3, 4, 5. Intersection of the two sets contain elements that are found in both sets. It has to be found in set 1 and in set 2. Well, there's only one element that actually satisfies this property, namely the element 3. Using symbols, we will write simply just element 3 for the intersection. Let's look at the set 1 intersects set 3. If we actually draw a Venn diagram here, it would be 1, 2, 3, it's 1, and it would be 5, 6. We happen to not share anything in common. which means in this case, none of the elements, or no element, is found in set 1 and in set 3 simultaneously. We would denote this as the empty set, which means the set of no element. When it comes to describing real numbers, there is actually an alternative or simpler way to describe sets of real numbers, and that's called interval notation. Let's start with some of the notations. First, we use the left open bracket to denote the starting point of your set does not include the left end point. And similarly, we use the right open bracket to describe the starting point of your set does not include the right end point. On the other hand, we use the left close bracket and the right close bracket to indicate that we want to include the left or the right end points. For example, the set with the left close bracket, negative 1 to 2, with the right open bracket, means the set builder notation, the set of all x's, such that negative 1 is less than or equal to x is less than 2. And its graphical counterpart on this real number line would then be represented by the following. You start with the real number line, which is denoted by this kind of a bold letter R. We mark down our left endpoint and the right endpoint, which in this case would be negative 1 and 2. And notice that because the left endpoint is actually included in our set, we're going to use a kind of a closed bracket notation, or you can actually use a solid dot on the real number line to indicate that. You can then use an open circle on 2 or a right open bracket to indicate that. And it's everything in between. So we're going to either make this a portion of the line really thick, or you can use the shading technique. Here's another example. If you want to describe the set negative infinity to 3, open on the negative infinity and then close on the 3, well, that's exactly the same as in the set builder notation, the set x, such that negative infinity is less than x, is less than or equal to 3. Well, notice that we always use the open bracket on infinity or negative infinity, because infinity is a concept, really is not a point, we can never reach it. That's why it's always open on infinity. Now, graphically, this represents the following. Again, you start with the real number line first. You mark down your right endpoint, in this case is 3. Again, negative infinity is a concept. It doesn't really exist on the real number line. We're just going to use an arrow notation to indicate that it's going to the negative infinity. And we wanted to actually include the right endpoint 3, hence we're going to use a solid dot here, and everything to the left of it would then be included in this set. Next, let's combine all the concepts we've learned so far to do the following exercises. Graph A, the set of all real numbers between 1 and 3, intersects the set of all real numbers between 2 and 7, and in part B, the set from 1 to 3, union the set that's from 2 to 7. Take a moment and do this yourself before you look at the solution next. For the first interval from 1 to 3, let's label 1 and 3 first. And then because it's open bracket, it's going to be open circle on both endpoints. And the set is everything in between. The second set from 2 to 7, 2 is in between 1 and 3 here, I'm going to label 2 here, and the 7 is all the way out here. It's actually closed bracket on both endpoints. I'm going to put down a solid dots on both points, and I want everything in between. Intersection here is telling us to find all the points that actually are found in both sets simultaneously. So visually, you're looking for the portion where these two sets kind of overlap with each other. So this actually corresponds to the set 2, 3, and 2 is closed because this 2 is closed. The 3 is actually open because this 3 right here is open. Once you figure out what your final solution looks like, you can actually graph that out on the real number line. It's going to be a closed on the 2, the solid dot, and open the circle on the 3. And I'm just going to draw everything in between to make it thicker. Okay, I'll try to do similar things for part B next. And the set from 1, 3 is shaded in here, and the set from 2, 7 is shaded in here. The union of the two sets is that basically you're looking for sets of numbers that are found in both sets, either or. So it's going to be basically everything from 1 to 7. 1 is going to be open, and 7 is going to be closed. Okay, and if you actually graph that, the solution there is just going to be an open on the 1 and close on the 7, and it's everything in between. And that's it.